We're recording a podcast. Let's do the thing where we notice that. Hello, notice me, senpai. Jesus Christ, where'd you come from?
Senpai, notice me.
Ah! All right. Hey, everyone. This is a bit of a milestone.
Is it?
It's a 10th podcast.
Oh.
Yeah.
There you go.
Cool.
Cool school.
Hey, everybody.
School cool.
This is the 10th questionable podcast.
Well, it's not the 10th questionable.
Well, it's all the same
thing. It's the 10th podcast.
Ever. From anyone.
The 10th podcast ever. That actually made sense.
Did it?
Well, it's the 10th ever. It's not going to be 10 again.
10 and a half.
No. It's not 10, though. That's not how grammar works. That's 10 and a half.
You're ruining the English language.
Don't care.
Yes, you do.
I actually don't.
Why not?
Because we all speak different languages in different ways.
And most of us are wrong. We're not.
No, I am.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
But always. We speak perfect language. Perfection.
Right.
Hey! We, and you know this too, have surpassed 1,700 subscribers.
Have we?
Yes, we have.
Oh, there you go.
1,706.
Woo!
So I was going to celebrate a little bit past, but considering how subscribers fluctuate, I was waiting until we got like five over. So 1,706 right now. Yay.
Woot.
Probably less when we upload this. But we're growing. Steadily, gradually, eventually, it'll happen. We've also we've entered the PewDiePie shout out competition
because we're Nazis.
Because we're Nazis, apparently.
Like PewDiePie.
Ah. he's gonna watch this exact video and like considering us. Then he's gonna go, oh no, no insult us.
He's not even a Nazi. He's complete bullshit.
But I've submitted it, the Outlaws Till the End or something, whatever that one was.
When we were on motorcycles.
Outlaws to the Core, yeah, because it was a Portal one.
And you were black.
And I was a black guy, because it's got a bit of offensive stuff, it showcases a decent amount of editing, more than usual, and it's a good showcase of us. So I'm just like, hey, this is what we'll do, let's pop it in, say who we are, and assume we're not going to win it in the slightest.
Ever.
No. Well, if it does, we don't know what to do with ourselves.
Keep doing what we're doing?
Yeah, but more.
No.
Why not?
One video a day.
I'm fine with one video a day. I mean, more. Well,
then
more,
we're going to keep doing what
effort.
We're doing.
Huh?
Then we're going to keep doing what we're doing.
More effort.
No.
More effort.
No.
More effort.
No.
I'm going to quit my job as a... No, hold on. Can't do that.
I'm going to get a job and then quit it.
You go in, finally get hired in a retail job, and they're just like... You're amazing.
Oh, no, I have been trying. Because of reserves.
That makes sense. Did you mention that?
Mm-hmm.
In the podcast?
Who cares?
For that matter? Who cares?
No.
Oh, they care, otherwise they wouldn't
be watching
this.
I already told him I was going
into it. He's going into it.
Yeah, exactly. Done.
It's been his birthday 2 days ago.
Yeah.
I got him just a Joker with an LMG.
That was cool.
Very sweet. Cool. I never give gifts.
I'm the only one you do.
Ah, pretty much. Often family.
Hmm.
Oh, well. Hey, let's actually get started with
questions.
I
had a shit last 48 days.
Or 48 not.
Days,
48 days.
Hours.
I've been counting.
How was your last 48 hours, Sedge?
Extremely tiresome and busy.
Because you've been working for MatPat.
Yeah, I've been working on a theory video.
And it's been fucking up crazy.
Oh, no, just Premiere itself.
Yeah, Premiere's a shit.
Yeah, it does that. It's like, oh, you can't handle three scenes above each other. Yeah. I don't know, it's freaking dumb. That's coming out fairly soon if you actually watch the channel. I don't. But I've hidden plenty of Easter eggs and even a little bit of racism.
Woo! Racism!
Yeah. It starts off with a Jewish reference.
Oh my god, Jews.
I know, it's great. But, hey, my last 48 hours have been tiresome, but also pretty okay. That's how about good. You?
Wow. Thanks for that setup there, Sedge.
Sedgeway.
Sedgeway.
That's going to be a thing. I'll make it a thing. Forced meme. Go on.
Yesterday, I fell down some stairs.
You almost said that with pride. Fell down some stairs.
At my missus' house, her parents have polished their staircase, which is wooden. They haven't got any grippy shit on it or anything like that. No, what's that black
carpet
strip you can get for the edge of the stair itself?
Black strip.
It's just the, like, the grip grippy, strip. It's just like a grip strip.
Cool.
And they haven't got any on there, and I fell down like six stairs after bouncing off my rib. That fucking hurt.
But did you die?
I did not die. Thank you.
Good.
And then...
asking the important questions.
Yeah. Then that happened, and I was like, ah, for fucking ages.
Doesn't your throat hurt?
Yeah.
Go to hospital.
And I didn't get any sleep last night because of it. Because if I laid on my side, it hurt.
Oh, shit,
if I laid on my back, it hurt. If I laid on the other side, it hurt.
Just lie standing up.
It hurt. And
pain everywhere.
And yeah, so that wasn't a very pleasant night. And couldn't get to sleep until like 3 o'clock in the morning. Then I got up at 6:30 and it was annoying. Then today on the road, went to go to the Le Mans go-kart center.
Oh, yeah.
Near Dandenong, or pretty much in Dandenong, South Dandenong. And just after I left, I was informed that the event was cancelled.
No.
I didn't know that.
No.
Because it was like 5 minutes, according to the message, after I left my house.
So you drove all the way there. And
so I drove all the way there to find out that it was cancelled, and I waited around for an hour.
Like uni.
And I waited around for an hour to see if anyone else was going to show up. And then on the way back, some stupid lady decided to turn off her car in the middle of the bloody highway.
Ah, good thinking. That sounds safe.
I was turning right to go onto the Gippsland Highway, and there was a lady in the turning lane, the only lane there is to go in.
Norwegian.
Turn off a car in front of me.
Was there any reason behind it?
No hazard lights, no nothing. She just stopped, turned off the car, and sat there.
If only there was a way of indicating that you were in a hazardous situation.
I sat there for about 10 seconds, and then I'm just like, beep, and she just goes, and the moon goes, and just, what am I doing wrong?
Well, you're not moving.
She was like, it's not like she was an old lady or anything that didn't know what the fuck she was doing or where she was, and she wasn't at Woolworths yet. She was at fucking, like, 30, maybe, at oldest.
What fuck?
Anyway, so after I go... and give her the fucking hold the horn down and get a bit upset, she finally puts her hazard lights on. She goes, in a fucking mirror. Meanwhile, there's another 10 people behind me.
So you couldn't get past?
No.
No.
I couldn't back up. I couldn't get past. There was another 10 people behind me, and we all had to get out of the car to go to the stupid bitch at the end who wouldn't back up and go around everyone. Bumper to bumper. And she won't back up to allow everyone else to back up to leave the fucking lane. So, fair enough, someone got, you know, stuck in the right-hand lane. She didn't put the hazard lights on, that's fine. She then turned off the hazard lights, turned the car on, and drove off. She was on a fucking hands-free phone having an argument with her husband.
Oh, fuck her right in the face.
Because I'm about to walk up to her fucking window. I'm like, can we push your car forward? She's like talking. And she's got a window open like this much. And she goes to drive off. She's like, all right, whatever. I'll see you back at home. Turns her car on, drives off.
Oh, whoops, my keys slipped all over the... Oh, they slipped over the right side too. And the, my gun slipped in your face.
Some people are so fucking inconsiderate of other people.
You say some, like it's not 99% of people on the fucking road. / public. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Them die. Them will die.
So then she, you know, turned her car on, went around the corner... and on the on-ramp onto the Gippsland Highway, pulled off to the side of the road and did the exact same thing again. But on the side of the road this time.
Oh, that's all right, then.
It's what she's supposed to do.
Yeah.
Not turn your fucking car off in a freaking right-hand lane where no one can get out. We were there for a total of about 3 minutes. That's ridiculous. There was a line of like 30 cars because the cars had spilled out of the right-hand lane and into the normal right-hand driving lane, the one that goes forward, not right. She didn't apologize. She didn't even acknowledge what she was doing. She just, okay.
It's my issue, therefore it's everyone's issue, because I'm the most important person on the road.
I mean, I know she was on a... Oh. She was angry at someone. I'm going to guess it was her husband or a boyfriend.
Or I hope she gets divorced.
Because she just goes, killed. Oh, whatever, I'll see you at home. And she's like screaming out a fucking window.
She's going to have children, already has children, and they're going to have horrible lives.
She's stupid, inconsiderate bitch in fucking some Audi A3.
You know what? I actually pictured an Audi the entire time you were saying that.
Black Audi A3.
I was getting red, but close enough.
I've even got a registration, but I'm not going to do that.
Yet. Unless you see it again. Let's get happy.
No, that just pissed me off.
I'm saying let's get happy.
No, I'm not done yet.
Oh, there's more?
Yeah.
How is there more?
Oh, there's more. I went to a shopping center nearby where Village is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Went to go see my missus before coming here to record.
Yeah.
Went to go get, just line up to get some stuff at the shopping center. And there was a lady there with a kid. And there's only one desk for the, where you go to get cigarettes, bullshit like that.
The main center bit.
Yeah. There was one lady with her kids at the front. And her kid was continuously begging his mother for a little dollar coin or like a 5-cent piece or some crap to put into that fountain.
The coin swirly thing.
The curl swirl thing. Yeah, you put it in the top and it rolls down and goes down. And goes. I find that amusing these days. That's cool.
Fantastic. And you also get the benefit of pretending that you're generous.
Yeah, I'm just amused. I'm not generous at all.
Yay.
I'm going to make those poor people work for their money by amusing me.
They actually chase it before it gets to the ground. If it goes in the thing, they just chuck it.
They have to dive in after and fight the others in there. Anyway.
What's the sound?
So, the lady at the desk is, she's going, what do you want? She goes, she wants the cigarettes and she wants this and that. And she goes to go pay for it and the kid is like, Mom, I want another one. He's fucking going off, he's fucking spassing. He goes, I just gave you one. He goes... Fuck you, Mum! Instead of her paying for the thing and yelling at the kid, she just goes, okay, honey, hang on. And stops paying the person with the other five people behind her waiting.
This is a deja vu here.
Yeah. This is all within an hour of each other, by the way. Fun. So I wasn't exactly in a great mood. and she goes to give the kid another coin. And she gave him a 20-cent coin. He wanted a $2 coin. He goes, you gave me the 20-cent coin last time.
20-cent one's the biggest. It's the most entertaining.
No, it's a 50. It's a 20 apart from the 50. But the 50's like hexagonal bullshit.
Yeah, it's got edges.
Yeah, and that's not as much fun on that thing.
Hell no.
So he wants the $2 coin.
Bitch.
And she goes, well, that's the only one I have. He goes, I don't want that one. I want the fucking 20-cent coin. A freaking $2 coin, sorry. And he's going off his fucking spaz and she's going through her purse while we're all waiting.
So then you pulled out your own coin thing with roughly 30 plus coins and shoved it all down his mouth one by one forcibly. Yes?
Anyway, she stopped and went, okay, here. And she turns back to the lady and goes, sorry about that. And the lady goes, it's all good. And she then proceeds to go pay for it. And the kid comes back and does the same thing again and starts tantruming and being a little cunt.
God, I hate children.
The mother is getting agitated, so she, goes to fucking tell the kid off. And the kid then swore at her again. She didn't tell him off for this or get any more angry. So I'm guessing that the kid knows absolutely no boundaries when it comes to his parents. Doesn't respect him.
She's given up.
Shouldn't have had the kid. No. You don't think you can handle it, don't have a kid. Anyway, that's why I'll never have kids. I don't want one.
That's not the only reason why, though. surely there's a lot of more reasons than just that.
No, I don't want a kid.
Yeah, I know, but more, there's greater reasons than just that they're little shits.
No, that's it.
Oh.
Really? I actually don't mind kids.
Oh.
I love my niece and my nephew. I love hanging out with them, but I also love being able to give them back. Simple as that.
Because it is a permanent, it's a permanent decision. It's not like you can't go back on it.
It's like if I choose between driving the car or driving the motorbike. If I'm on the motorbike on a rainy day and it's slippery and horrible, I don't want to be on the motorbike. I want to be in the car. You have a kid, you're permanently with it.
Well, that's the thing. That's the only example, really. The kid is permanent.
Yeah.
There's no other greater thing than that, because you can go back on almost any other decision or even just rectify it in some way. You can't do that with a kid. You made it. You fucked up. It is your responsibility now.
It's ridiculous.
Which is why some people are actually antenatal, which means they think, at least on a philosophical level, that people shouldn't have kids in the first place because the parents are responsible for everything wrong that happens to the child.
Yeah.
By creating them.
I mean, some kids are obviously a lot more of a cunt than others.
Oh, yeah, of course. It's not saying, like, every single child is atrocious.
Yeah.
But
some parents don't know how to just fucking discipline the little shit, or they do it too much.
Mm.
And if they do it too much, the fucking kid will wait until he's away from his parents and then be a complete utter cunt somewhere else. Like at school. And then the teacher's got to put up with that shit.
Some anyway. Parents get super dismissive during the parent-teacher.
Just to finish what I was saying.
Do go on.
So, instead of her completing her transaction of, you know, getting out of the fucking way, the kid is tantruming on the ground and she's stopped doing what she's doing to go deal with the kid. The lady behind the desk, and this is the bit that pissed me off. The lady behind the desk very politely said, "Ma'am, could you please just pay for your items because we have people behind you?" She didn't say it like that, but she was very, very polite about it.
Okay.
The lady cracked the shits.
Oh, okay. There you go.
She goes, "My son is doing this, my son is doing that, and these people can fucking wait." I was like, "Oh, I wonder where the dirty mouth comes from." I mean, don't get me wrong, I swear like a fucking sailor, but I didn't when I was a child. I started doing that when I was about 16. So, yeah. And it was, we waited like 10 minutes just for this kid to get another 20 cent coin eventually. I don't know. And then it turned out the dad was like sitting on a bench, like 5 meters away, watching it all happen.
That's a common family in our state, unfortunately. Can we lighten up the mood, please?
Oh, it pissed me off so much. That's why I'm all grumpy face.
On to the questions. So, because you know,
and I haven't eaten lunch and I'm hungry.
Okay, well that is not a problem. First person. Broom Broom Pow. That's a new person. I haven't seen you before. First, please pin me.
No.
No.
Give us something constructive.
Exactly. If you can't just say, "Please pin me," or "pin me," or don't do that. I don't care how politely you ask. You got to earn that shit.
Also, I do not have a pin. It is just a bit bigger than a pin.
You know, it's a reference to the actual YouTube pin where you've been.
Yes, and I was referring to my penis.
That's disgusting.
Mm.
You don't have a pin cock.
I know, I just said that.
You have a man cock.
I have slightly bigger than a pin cock.
Oh!
It's like, it's not like a pin, it's like one of those needles that have like the little bit of the end. So it's a little bit thicker than a pin.
Like a thermometer?
No.
No?
It's like a threading needle. And it's got the big circle at the end.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's like
so
that.
So you loop things through it.
Yeah.
And so?
Yeah, with my cock.
What?
I don't know. Anyway.
James Grimer, hello again, says Smeagol. I'm guessing that's the picture.
Yes.
That's like a skull from my...
No, he's Smeagol.
Yeah. On to Mr. Grimer again.
Yep.
Pineapple makes your semen taste better.
Have you got evidence of this? Personal experience?
Nice.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, we can try it out.
Does it make it smell better? Because that stuff smells disgusting, as you can probably tell.
It's just like, it's like musky. It's weird.
Get an air freshener for your cock or something. We should make that. We should patent that. We need a creative name, though. A pee freshener. No, that doesn't really work.
Cock freshener.
A bear freshener for the hairy gay guy in you. Not literally. Nasty.
That means two things. Now, that's the LGTB branch of our cologne.
Wasn't that the initials for the first GTA 4 DLC?
I don't know.
The Ballad of Transsexual Tony. Gravy. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. Number 9. I can't believe you missed a perfectly good Big Smoke joke. No.
Where?
You got to put the time code in, man.
Come on, man. I mean, not that we're going to look at it, code, but this, come on, man.
You got to put it in. It's reference.
It's like Sedge continuously forgetting the links.
I use most of them. I'm sure I forgot one or two, but you got to look through it, man, and say,
anyway,
a link. I'm sure they'll be in the comments saying, you forgot this! Okay. Memories. Pineapple and pizza is gross, but it's better than pineapple and a burger, you sick fucks.
No.
I mean, it's subjective, but also you're wrong.
No, it's purely subjective, and I agree, we are sick fucks.
Look, I'll be honest, I haven't actually had pineapple on pizza in years.
What about Hawaiian?
Like, ages. No, I haven't had Hawaiian pizza in ages.
I think Hawaiian is boring as fuck. I'm pretty sure we've been over this as well.
I think so. Well, and then again, Hawaiian is almost like an Aussie. There's an Aussie pizza which is just ham, cheese, and egg, I think. Yeah. It's with sauce, of course.
And bacon.
And bacon, yeah. That's nice.
Mm.
I like that pizza.
Because it's nothing but a carnivore's meal.
Yeah. But then you have the actual meat lovers.
Speaking of which, one pizza tonight?
I haven't had pizza for ages, so hell yeah, nigga.
Awesome.
And if you want some lunch, you can have the parma I made, because I got a whole parma ready for you.
I need a fucking parma then. Can I eat it while we're recording?
Yeah, sure, go grab it. It's in the fridge. It's under some foil.
Is there anything else with it? I'll just have it on its own.
It's literally just a parma.
Okay.
You know where the cutlery is. I'm going to answer a few more questions from Mr. Rafugi, unless they're related to you.
Okay.
Hold on. Yeah, that's probably right.
Go for it.
And get beaten up by an Asian lady man. Man lady. Scoot. Scoot. It's like in the middle of the fridge.
Okay.
You'll see it. It's foil on a plate. Hey. So organized. There's a shotgun in my face. So yeah. Pineapple. I kind of want to try it again before judging, but I've had it on burger more recently than I have a pizza, and that was all right. I actually don't really like beetroot either. That's a really common side thing for burgers. So, yummy scrumptious. Rafugi continues to say a completely different sentence. You're right. Cheaper medicines like home brand do the same thing. Panadol and Nurofen come in a fancy sugar coating that make it not taste like shit. Well, it sits in the tongue before you swallow it. If the medicine didn't do what it said, it wouldn't be allowed to be sold in stores. That's very true. Except sometimes when the medicine says very, very... I was going to say bland, that's not the right word. They say very broad sentences like, it'll help your pain. And like, you know, if it slightly reduces it by 0.01%, that's still helping. Like, it still advertises that. It's like the things which say, contains 0 calories. I'm fairly sure, at least in America, if it contains 5 or less calories, it can legally be stated as 0 calories, despite actually having some in it. And fair enough with the sugar thing. I don't know, most people actually put it on their tongue and then they do it. I just go, blip that, like that. Medicine usually tastes like shit anyway, so if you're going to have it, doesn't really matter. I guess that's also up to preference still. But, yeah, fair enough. They do have the general same purpose. It just depends on whether you like the taste or not. It's like premium and normal. They're both the same thing, but one of them is just slightly better and much more expensive. Okay. Rafugi also says, I feel so alone. He doesn't say that. That's I'm saying that. I rarely go to Time Zone, but the option is there because I live there. Nice. Very nice. I'm really surprised they're still open. People like video games. But we live near the beach. Like, maybe a 10-minute walk away tops. Like, it's just over there.
The beach.
No, it's even live near the beach.
Yeah.
Like, I live a walk away.
You're fucking 5 minutes.
Yeah, barely that.
Hate the beach.
But I never go.
Beach sucks.
I'll be honest.
It's grainy and it's rough and it's sand. It gets everywhere.
It's coarse and it's rough. And it gets everywhere.
Fucking Anakin.
How good's that palmer?
I have no idea. I haven't eaten it.
Especially brand new.
It's still cold, so...
Cold palmer's great.
I love cold palmer. Anyway, I'm going to eat in front of all y'all.
Nice. Rafugi was saying that he doesn't go to Time Zone that much, but he lives really close to it.
You've
so
soaked this.
No, I actually cooked it in the sauce this time. But it's like full on. I think it's quite okay. Not worth all the effort.
Wow.
But I think it's quite a delicious thing. I put a bit of garlic in there.
Where'd you get the chicken?
I just got some chicken breasts from Woolies.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I bashed it with a rolling pin, which is always good fun. And I'm the Palmer masturbator. I still would like a crispy one. Crisp the top. Back on topic. But yeah, the beach is over there. But I don't go because I'm self-conscious about my topless body. And it's cold as fuck. But who knows when I get fit by my birthday, that's October the 3rd, I might go, hey, I don't look unattractive anymore. Sweet.
You're not going to the beach once. No, you won't.
Go once. I went last year for Christmas. It was packed as fuck and I slept. And then an Indian family came behind me and they were talking about me, I think.
Mm.
I think so. Judgmental bastards. That's not the right word. Hey, why don't you look at the next one and read it with your mouth full?
Oh, okay, well, I just finished the food.
We'll have another fucking mouthful then.
Which one are we up to?
Eat my food!
Which one?
Well, it's a time zone one, so it's above the middle. So, this is a really good time zone. We've already done that one.
Oh, right.
It's the one above that. Ow.
Okay, hang on. Let me put some food in my mouth.
Yeah, put all of that right in there.
Jesus Christ. It's fucking thick.
Well, I tried to bash it a lot, but it didn't get any thinner.
Oh, no.
But it's cooked.
Ah!
Jesus Christ, man. Eat like a woman, not like a Dan. This one.
Nothing bad ever happens to goldfish. Brisbane and more north got fucked up and south of us got flooding. But the Gold Coast is like the mirror dimension in Doctor Strange. All the bad shit just misses us. It's amazing.
Really?
No, well, lucky you.
Cool.
Very lucky you.
That's alright. I mean, still kind of fucked up for everyone else. Actually, that's a fair point. The worst thing I've heard in the Gold Coast that happened was the flippin' squish. From Dreamworld or whatever it was. Squish from you. Ah, twins! Oh, and the schoolies. Oh, how do you suffer with schoolies if you live in the Gold Coast? That's got to be atrocious. Unless you're like a person who likes that sort of shit. But, fuck that. Every time, like, my neighbors, well, my neighbors actually are okay in this place, but my old place, whenever they had a party,
oh, yeah,
they were as loud as they possibly can be.
Yeah, not to mention the increase in traffic and the prices would go up and bullshit like that.
Fucking hell, screw that.
Sound like grumpy old men.
We are grumpy old men. I've been a grumpy old man for my whole fucking life.
It's a good point, even when he came out.
Imagine a grumpy man, but without the whole wiseness that, yeah, I don't have years of experience, I just am cynical.
Right. Isn't that great? James Garner.
Oh, hold on a second. Got a bunch of replies. Ba-bam.
Ex-tropical cyclone Debbie was a fucking cunt.
They mostly all are cunts.
Yeah, pretty much.
I won't disagree with that. Yeah.
Rufugi replied with, you live in northern Queensland. Hey, at least it wasn't as bad as 2010, 2011. I have no idea. Didn't pay attention.
Shit happened.
Nah, mate, I lived on the Gold Coast. It wasn't as bad as the sunny coast, but we received some damage. 2010, 2011 was indeed a massive pain in the ass. School started a month late because of it.
Is that a bad thing?
Probably is, because then it goes for another month.
Oh, that's a bad
longer,
thing,
most
yeah.
likely. Or they have to do more than a small amount of
fucked
time.
Fucked on a homework yeah. and shit, yeah.
I lived in a surf... I live in
live
surfers.
In the surfboard.
And all got was rain and wind for one night. The next day... It looks like nothing had happened. It's like we live in bubble here.
We live in bubble.
We live in a bubble here.
Duh. It's bubble.
I moved here mid-2012, though, so I missed the whole 2011 fiasco.
Well, that's all right.
Yeah.
We haven't had anything like terrible that's happened in our area.
Not that I can remember, anyway.
Nothing major.
Oh, no, the power went out.
Oh. I remember. We all remember them. It's like slight winds, and it's got like a picture of a deck chair that's fallen yeah. over, and it's just like.
It's not like a heavy deck chair. It's like no, the plastic it's ones,
shitty plastic,
the one. White plastic ones.
No, all the crap that happens in the town near us, Afghanistan with an F.
What a wonderful place! I almost didn't know what you were talking about.
Oh, you know exactly what it's about. That. Yeah. But no, it's pretty okay here. We had like a murder ages ago, but that's pretty much it.
Said you forgot the links that were actually important, the stamper ones.
I forgot the stamper ones? Ah, oh, dicks. I'll probably put them in this one. I don't know. Again, I keep forgetting. But you know, if we mention it and I forget to do it, thanks for the reminder, but also search for it. Because we've given you enough information, probably.
No, we haven't.
Go to Stamper's channel and watch everything he's got.
There you go.
He's a fantastic funny man.
All right. Refugi 11.
Hello.
11? 11. Again.
Where'd that
fucking
come from?
33, I don't know. In winter it gets cold, but I love the heat. 9 months of fire!
Jesus Christ.
On the Gold Coast, that is. 9 months
of fire!
It helps that I live 1 minute from walk from the beach.
Hey, same here.
He lives even closer than we do.
But you get used to it, really. I like, I never explained it last time, I like Melbourne's weather because it's never consistent. And yeah. I never go out, so it doesn't really matter.
Mm.
But from a practical general perspective, I prefer cold weather because you can snuggle up.
Mm.
You need to put stuff on. You can't, like, take all your skin off when it gets hot.
All right, back to Geimer.
Geimer.
We can handle the heat up here because we climatized to it. There you go.
Fair enough.
You got another one. I agree with Dan. Camping in the cold is absolutely amazing. Especially at night time when you've got a fire and marshmallows.
That's
inside
right.
the
Not
tent.
Not if it's like fucking inside the tent. Problem solved. If it's fucking freezing and your nose is running and bullshit, that's horrible. You can never get to sleep. But when it's like a nice cold, like a good blend, then yeah, that's pretty cool.
You look up Thank you, sir. That Palmer was great.
You're welcome. I'm a cuisinist. I put a fuck ton of garlic
I in. Might just put a ring on your finger so you can cook all my meals for me.
That's not gonna happen. I just make Palmers all the time.
I'm okay with this.
Yeah, it's a pretty good life.
Okay.
Why am I not your wife?
Don't know, mate.
I got tits.
Oh, wait, no, shit, I can't have dinner with you tonight.
Why not?
I'm having Mexican with Kate.
I'm devastated.
Sorry, mate. Tomorrow?
Yeah, all right.
Perfect. Done. If you guys are looking for a good video game soundtrack, I'd suggest Killer Instinct, the most recent one.
I got that, but I haven't
it
seen it.
It says recent.
Recent.
It doesn't say recent.
Resent.
It's the most recent one.
Most resentful one. Disgusting.
That was Professor Walter.
Is it a new person?
I think so.
I don't recognize him. Hello.
I don't recognize his thumbnail unless he's...
Disgusting.
<changed it.
laughs> Ew.
Okay. James Geimer.
Hello.
Have you guys ever been to a Cold Rock ice cream shop?
Yeah.
Yes, we have. We used to have one right nearby.
Yeah, it's gone now.
It's gone now, but it was awesome and very, very, very small servings.
Don't they still have it?
No.
Oh, no, it's replaced with like a kebab shop now, isn't it? Yeah.
No, it's a souvlaki joint.
Oh, same thing. Okay. But I don't continue. I fucking love that place.
No.
The Cold Rock. But once I'm just like, okay, I kind of want to get like $100 and just get all the toppings and stuff. But I'm just like, okay, I have a better idea. So I got some cookie dough and some like ice cream and stuff
with
a mate.
I was with you with that.
Huh?
That was me.
That makes sense. Anyway, we just mashed it together ourselves.
Yeah, you were in my, we were sitting on my back porch.
That was delicious.
That was like 5 years ago.
That makes Cold Rock redundant.
Yeah, it does. Okay. The burgers are not better at Hungry Jack's.
Oh, it depends.
Go to McDonald's.
Yeah.
No.
I think I prefer them at Hungry Jack's in regards to
Oh,
McDonald's.
Porto's not bad.
Oh, Porto's good because like grilled. It actually feels
I wish they did
fresh.
More meat, though.
Yeah, apart from just chicken.
Yeah. They'd I mean, I understand that's their thing, but, you know, it'd be nice. You got like pork
out,
or fucking beef or...
Oh, porco.
Lamb.
It likes
some
itself.
Shit like that.
Even, the thing about, like, general fast food is, even if it tastes good... You have a shitty person making it. Like, you got the newbie who doesn't know what the fuck they're doing. They put the 5 tons of used lettuce in there and then a little tiny little patty.
Apart from Subway.
What?
Subway.
What
it's not
mean?
The same.
What do you mean it's not the same?
If it's a shit person making it and the fucking thing falls apart when you're trying to eat it or it's not packed correctly inside the actual sub, it's crap.
Yeah.
Or if there's too much lettuce here and not over here or too much pepper in the middle and... Ah!
It's always different depending where you go.
Yeah.
I went to one which had a meatball sub, which was a meatball in a sub. Not even kidding. It was
one
near uni.
Meatball.
They're in a rush and just like, hi, I know it's a meatball sub, but I could I have more, please?
I wasn't being literal.
Please, sir.
Please, sir.
Fuck you.
Could I have more than one? All right. James Geimer. I want to try the chicken palmy pie, you cunts.
Yeah, that sounds delicious.
All right, then do it.
Hey, wouldn't a palmer be nice? Don't you think?
Yeah, Palmer's great.
Yeah.
Refugi, 33.
Yes.
Yeah, we have Wendy's, the ice cream place in New South Wales and Queensland too.
I think it's a national company, but yeah, they've completely fucked over almost any chance of us actually having the decent Wendy's. Well, actually, no, Wendy's is okay.
And he also says,
expensive.
Turnbull is a fuckhead. I think we can all agree on that.
Yeah.
My little brother likes him. some reason.
Why?
I don't know.
He just give a reason, or he just likes him?
He gave reasons, and they actually did make sense, but I just didn't really care.
Because he's a cunt. Yeah. Don't bother scrolling, because it's going to be like the middle of the screen.
Don't care.
It's like a good focus. I'm going to keep it right in the middle.
I don't care. Achievement Hunter Halo Fails of the Week was awesome by James Gunner.
It got old a bit fast, though. They made like 200 and something plus, and this is like, okay, there's not really original stuff. It's just, they were even getting sick of it. It was mostly Jack and Jeff from Achievement Hunter, and they were just like, oh, wow.
Hey, Dan.
I want to ask this one because it's to you.
Okay.
Here you go.
Oh, boy.
Hey, Dan. Tell us how you feel about the removable paddles on the Xbox One Elite controllers. Do go on.
Why should I?
Kind of already have.
They're shit.
Look, you get used to them. Same with the longer thumbsticks. I can barely go. I can like use the normal controller still, but the longer thumbsticks make it so much better.
In all honesty, I actually think it's a cool idea. Like, very, very cool.
Needs to be stronger magnets.
That kind of stuff. And yes, it does need to be stronger magnets. Because before I was just like, oh, yeah, shit.
You can't play skate with it. It just goes straight down. Is it? Sorry.
But this, I would have to get used to.
Mm.
But I think it's actually a very cool idea.
Yeah, well, that's why I took off, because it's got four paddles on the back. I actually take off the bottom two, because only you need two of them.
Yeah.
And I'm fairly sure, because you got like two settings on the front, like one and two. The right setting is so I can do this in GTA quickly, because instead of like doing the thumbsticks, you just press on the back paddles. So much easier. The left setting is default controller. I bought a 200 controller just to thrust.
Just to thrust in GTA. That's dedication to your thrusting, my friend. Well done.
Anyway, that means
they're actually not bad. I'm just an uncoordinated fuck.
Yay! Sedge sexually identifies as a snow leopard. Who told you?
Do you really? How many spots do you have?
I need to earn all my spots before the transformation can be complete. Did you know snow leopards can't actually, like, roar? They don't have the same...
Do they meow?
They chuff.
They chuff?
They go like that. It's called chuffing.
The fuck?
I'm chafing. Because they don't actually have the... I think it's like not the larynx. It's something in the throat that actually causes the roar to happen in most feline.
Okay.
But they actually don't have it.
So they do the same hunting kind of thing that cats do.
Yeah. They're all cats.
And they click and shit.
Yeah. But they actually cannot roar. Fun facts of the week.
There you go.
You're learning.
Fun facts with Sedge and Dan.
Please actually check that. Because I learned that a while ago. We are not valid sources of information.
Do not use us.
Platypuses. Platypi. Oh, awesome. Yes. Also, the game's fun too.
What game?
It's a side-scrolling game made with claymation.
Okay.
It's really cool. Platypi are the most confusing fucking animal ever. They're poisonous.
Yeah.
They look like duck beavers.
They're adorable until they're not.
They lay eggs, but they're a marsupial.
Yeah.
They have like... Oh, they're awesome. At least they're cute. If they were ugly as fuck, it'd be like, you're an abomination to nature.
They're just the right like combination to be cute.
Yeah,
probably
because
they're furry. Are they furry or just hairy? Like, would that be... That's not fur. What would it be?
Well, fur... I think that there's a difference between fur and hair. I think hair is sheddable. Fur is not.
So, they're furry.
So, do they shed? I don't know.
I have no idea if they shed. I'm not a platypus expert.
Why not?
Because.
I can't do it. I can't do that. You've seen Phineas and Ferb?
Yeah.
You know the little parody of the platypus? It's really difficult. D. Bradley Baker, guys. See, I know voice actors. Yeah, that's the guy that voices Klaus from American Dad. He's really fucking talented with animal noises. God, I love voice actors. He is. There's pigs and stuff. But even better than that.
Oink!
He was the pig from Gravity Falls.
Oh, there you go.
Great.
Anyway.
I think Dan's got the right idea about music. If it sounds good, listen to it. You don't have to listen to one specific type of music.
There you go.
I completely agree.
No,
but again, this music that I don't like objectively, I usually also don't like audibly.
You're also very biased.
I am. Of course I'm very biased.
Yes.
But I've been less so recently.
Yes.
But even still... If I don't like a song, it's initially because it sounds bad or it's like repetitive, which is already really annoying. I mean, repetition's a key element of music, but too repetitive.
Repetition's a key element of music.
A pinky element of music.
Yum.
But I think fair enough. Don't like listen to it if you don't like it, sort of thing.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Don't listen to it because other people listen to it.
Obviously,
or vice versa.
Fucking Skrillex.
Oh, God. Yeah. But I still think music itself has actually been the most... vast and different this year. Like, it just keeps broadening out and stuff. Okay. What the fuck did this turn into? Sedge's dating video?
Yes. Part How you one. Doing?
Part two has only just begun.
Play more Hoonie Pop.
I wasn't finished.
Yes, you were.
I need to do a dating video.
No.
Or a conclusive dating no. video. Hey, everybody.
No.
I'm actually looking for a girlfriend because I no. respect my free time too much.
There you go.
So, unless you're, like, absolutely perfect or, like, you know, other good reasons.
Then why
and stuff,
would you not? Then why would you make the video?
Uh-huh.
Why would you make the video?
Oh, I didn't make it on purpose.
Yes, you did.
This just happened.
You're doing it right now. You just stopped us from moving on
That's
to make
ridiculous.
The video.
I'm not stopping from Sedge. Moving on. I'm just concluding. This isn't me winking. I'm actually having a terrible seizure. Oh, play more Honey Pop. Actually, it says Hoonie Pop. I hate you now. Fuck you, Rafugi.
That's why I just read it like that.
Bastard, I'm kind of used to you saying it now. You son of a bitch. We'll get back to it eventually. I don't see why not. But we will be terrible at it.
Here you go.
That's all right. Oh, no.
James Yarmer.
Pretty cute.
I had a paranormal experience at Port Ooh. Arthur during the night tour. What was it?
Oh, you just said that. Elaborate, man. Fair enough for answering the question, but
what happened?
Like, yeah. You don't just say, I had an experience. Okay, go on. No, that's it. I just had an experience.
It's okay. Just give us, is there more to come? It's like a spoiler.
Or is it something you wanted to forget? It Ooh. Was so atrocious. Oh, now I'm intrigued.
Were you, like, raped?
Ghost rape.
You chalked it up to a paranormal experience?
I was just a really, really white guy.
Yeah. Or he was black and you just couldn't see him in the dark.
Oh. You can certainly feel him.
Ooh.
Ghost cock.
Ghost big 12-inch cock.
Okay. I actually do not envy people with massive dicks.
Nor do
Just
I.
Just a little side note, because, like...
My 3.5 inches when erect is fine with me.
I know it is. Because, like, you know, from a general perspective, if you have a shower rather than a grower, yes, we're getting into this now, it's very impractical.
Because,
fair enough, it does the job and stuff.
Well, I personally have a grower.
You gotta... Yeah, damn straight.
Yeah, I gotta grow up.
And when it's really cold, you know, you can fit it in women's panties if you really want to.
You can put tight underwear on to make it bigger. Anyway.
But hey, whatever gets the job done, you just gotta tickle it out of its groundhog hole.
Refugi.
Refugi.
Kangaroo is lit as fuck. Have you eaten crocodile?
Yes.
Also, what the fuck are the coat of arms? What is England's national animal? A fox or some shit?
Well, to answer the first thingy, yeah, I've eaten crocodile.
I have too.
It's like a rubbery fish. Doesn't have much of a taste.
I didn't like it.
Nah, I wouldn't mind having it again, but wouldn't.
Its texture was like really, like...
It's rubbery.
Yeah.
It's almost like a spongy fish.
Yeah.
Like, unpleasant.
It's gross.
It's not worth it.
It's like having jelly.
But not even that.
Really, really hard jelly.
Yeah. But with the coat, what are other coat of arms? I don't know. We only care about Australians. We're ignorant bastards. Why would you want to care about anyone else?
I say
with
guys.
Partial sarcasm. What is England's national animal? Oh, Brexit. I don't know why I said that. It's an animal now. It's a little disgusting creature that goes, make UK great again.
UK's national animal is a tea bag with...
With legs and a
with
head
legs
and a tail.
And a head and... When it goes into the water, it pours itself out into its mother. That's a teapot.
It's called a crumpet with 3 Ks.
There you go.
I don't know why I said
crunket.
That.
Crunket. It's a crocodile. Okay.
Nice reference to The Simpsons.
Major trip hazard. A trio of lions, personally. I haven't tried to eat one of those. It's usually the other way round.
Oh, that explains Queen's, like, logo. Okay.
Okay.
And because the Queen is British.
Ah! Do Uganda eat springbok and ostrich? It seems like something they do. Typical
Uganda.
Stop it, you.
I mean, ostrich wouldn't be too bad because it's a bird.
That's right.
And birds taste okay. I'd give
they'd be a
shot.
Bit. They'd be like fucking. Oh, the.
No, people eat ostrich.
It'd
eggs.
Be hard to not get like the adrenaline soak into the meat because they're
yeah.
very like kind of animals.
They're Roger Rabbit.
Yeah.
But ostrich.
Please, Eddie.
Oscar Ostrich.
Yeah.
It just rides itself again.
Oscar
Gambling
Ostrich.
Creative.
They're Roger Rabbit ostriches.
Please, they Roger the Rabbit. Oh.
You trying to tell me you can get your hands out of there at any time? Of course not, Eddie. Only when it's funny.
What a great film.
It's a great film.
I I just generally try any animal, really. Fucking, I try person if you know.
Except a penguin.
You wouldn't try penguin?
No, Kate would kill me.
Oh, no. Just eat it anyway.
Then she'd eat me.
I mean, what if it had to be culled? What if there were too many penguins? Like then the Futurama episode. Yeah, but then you'd eat them. Because not just shooting them is like, okay.
Nah, I'll give them to seals. And then the seals will grow in numbers. And then we'll shoot them.
And then
we'll give them to kill whales.
Yep.
And then the killer whales grow in numbers. And then they'll take over everything and we're fucked.
Killer whales are scarily smart.
Oh, fuck yes they are. They're fucking. You've seen that video of the seal sitting on the fucking rock and...
Well, I was there when you showed me it, so yes.
Oh, yeah.
Like, three of them, like, make a wave and knock off the seal.
Yeah, they make a wave and knock it off.
Smart bastards.
Little cunts.
It's a gamer.
I agree with Major Trip Hazard. Seeing your reactions is priceless.
I definitely miss the webcam thing, though. Or just the face cam in general, because... Editing it is so much more fun. Like, Dan has started to edit. He's still getting the technical stuff down. The general editing's fine, but the technical bullshit, which you'll face a lot, is so bad.
Yeah.
So, is why you mightn't have seen a video on Monday and or Tuesday, because I'm super busy and Dan was working on something, but something screwed up, which is okay. Face cam as much as possible, as long as we remember.
Mm.
It's hard to forget, considering it's like right there.
Okay. The Overwatch track... Soundtracks are pretty cool.
I did like the music.
Yeah,
it's very dramatic and it's memorable too.
Play of the game.
Play of the game.
Dramatic stuff. James Geimer.
Hello.
I did get away with hijacking the school loudspeaker mic. That was fucking hilarious. What'd you do?
What'd you say? I'm sure you didn't say anything terrible.
Fuck you, Mr. Garrison.
You remember, Dan, we were... like trying to plan a sort of prank.
Yeah, we were.
For the end of the school. And the initial one was considered like we're going to... At the front of our old high school, it's elementary school for you Americans. We had like a... We still have it, an LED board.
Yeah.
And it says like, congratulations on the class of 20, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, this is a waste of money.
Yes.
And I was considering like seeing how to try and hack it. And I tried to do it and I couldn't figure out a proper way to do it without actually being in the place where they type it in, which is not worth it because I had a good record, mostly.
You were a good boy.
Good boy. Not achieving, but not losing. Yes, it's okay. But that didn't work out.
Well, tell us what you did, mate. What did you play through the bloody speakers?
Sandstorm? Or that thing from the 4chan... Where they connected from the 4chan. Connected to the school loudspeakers manually, wirelessly, and played the modified re-sung DuckTales theme. You'll know what it is if I say 4chan plus DuckTales.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, Refugi, sleeping naked is too much. How do you do it? Well, I get into bed naked and I sleep.
You take your clothes off, you get into your bed, and you close your eyes.
No. Can you not get undressed, mate?
His clothes are stuck to him permanently. He had a horrible PVC accident in primary school.
Oh,
happens to the best of us.
Yeah, no. I sleep naked by sleeping naked.
It really depends on your situation, too. Like I said, I don't feel comfortable showing my squish, squish, squish to everybody.
Well, you're not supposed to be sleeping in front of everybody else.
Well, yeah, exactly. But sometimes, like, it depends on how much your family and people living in your house respect your privacy.
Mm.
I live at the top of the stairs and no one really comes into my room.
He lives at the top of the stairs. Not in a room, just at the top of the stairs.
I almost exclusively communicate to my friends, family, sorry, through text. Not even kidding. I think you look at my text records in the past like 12 have been dinner's ready, dinner.
My mum just shouts even though we can't hear her from the other end.
That's
all
right. We really need a studio.
What my mum will do is she'll shout. She'll be like fucking five rooms away, shout, move another room in, shout, move another room in, shout, all right, I got it. Go back to five rooms. Oh, and also, no, fuck. And then she'll try it again.
You can see there's a certain level of respect there. Partial sarcasm. Oh, Mr. Geimer! Again.
Max Brenner's is the best.
Yes, have you been there yet?
No.
You got to go there with Kate.
No, I haven't.
I don't care whether you care if it's in the city or not. It is totally
worth
it. It is fucking amazing. And not just the hot chocolate, but it is the best part of it. So definitely go there for the
James,
hot chocolate.
James, Geimer again. Nice. Cities are shit. I prefer rainforest areas like Tamarine Mountain.
I do like rainforests. That's pretty fun to very walk cool. through and stuff.
Very cool.
Yeah. Except almost every time, maybe half of every time I've gone to a rainforest or a hike or something, I've always tripped over and fell. Or someone else has. And there was one situation at Badger's Creek. Remember that place?
Badger's Creek. Yep.
Mushroom. Where, you know the bush turkeys? The bush hens? Little bastards.
Oh.
Yeah. They stole my nut bag.
Oh, no. Did you get your nuts back?
I didn't get my nuts back.
How many of your nuts did they take?
A whole sack of nuts.
Did you get nibbles?
My family's nuts.
Oh, no.
Nibbles could not chew on my ball sack because...
The little pigeons took your nuts.
Those guys are bastards. Apparently in... Exactly. Apparently in Sydney, they call them... I was going to say, like, not rats, like seagulls. I forgot what they called them. Someone did a parody David Attenborough documentary on them.
Okay.
They're the ibises. They got the massive beaks. Yeah. And bin turkeys. That's what they call them.
Bin turkeys.
And they're a scourge on things. And they, like, ruin the rubbish bins just to get food and stuff. But from another perspective, you kind of took over their environment. They're just adapting. That's what people animals do.
People animals.
People animals. We are at people animals.
This is more directed at you, mate. Hello. I think this was more you. Okay. Charlie and Boots is not a kid's film. It's an M-rated comedy, I think.
Like it.
And it features Paul Hogan.
Oh, I think I've heard about it. I think it's an Australian film.
I got nothing.
I'll definitely give it a shot. I haven't seen it. I mean, you mentioned in the previous thing, we just haven't even watched any of the movies that you suggested.
No.
We will.
Maybe.
Most of them. Some of them. But no, I'm definitely willing to watch. That seems all right.
I recently heard about a Steam game called Angels with Scaly Wings.
Never heard of it.
Would you guys be interested in playing it and possibly reviewing it? It costs $10. You want to have a look at it?
Maybe. Fuck it, let's look. Oh, yeah, we actually have a thing up. Okay. Keep it on the same tab. Just open up a new tab. Watch out. Okay.
What was it called?
Angels with Scaly Wings.
Nope. Can't be that great.
It's not going to... Angy? No.
Why?
Skangles Wangles. Wee.
Fucking dude. I'm just going to write that.
Don't mean it. Angels with Skull.
Angels with Skull.
I just clicked on that, but okay. Let's have a gander. It looks like a dating sim.
It is a dating sim.
Oh, it is a dating sim.
Aww.
Very different reactions.
Bear the dragon.
He builds things. Is it gay? You, the player, are ambassador to Earth.
Wait, what?
Oh. Sent through a mysterious portal into the world of dragons. Explore a town full of secrets.
Are they all,
the
people who are keep they all them male dragons?
Sci-fi visual novel.
They all look like male
they
dragons.
Look like it.
Unless you're supposed to be a female character.
Oh, that'll be all right then.
Yeah, they all look like males.
Mm. My dragons are pretty gay.
Even... Oh no, that one's got eyelashes like that.
Faggins.
Are fancy. Faggin dragon. Fag dragons, faggins.
Faggin the dragon.
That one's got like the eyelashes, so...
Beautiful.
Maybe it's some female.
Hey, it doesn't matter what you think, as long as... No, it doesn't
matter. Let's go get us some dragon penis.
I really want to get out of here and be bombarded. There we go. Did you say let's go get dragon penis?
Yeah.
Bad dragon. Away.
Bad dragon.
Scrolly. Uppy wuppy.
Scrolly. That'll do it. Holy.
James Garner.
Yeah.
Assassin's Creed 2 has a pretty good soundtrack. Search Ezio's Family. I've heard it.
As have I.
I've played it. That is one of the best Assassin's Creed games.
One of the last good ones.
Black Flag was great.
Fucking ending.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I know the whole... It's partial spoiler, I'm sure you don't give a shit. The whole alien bullshit that they're going with is like, okay, I get it, and it kind of works, but that was what was made me reluctant to actually play Black Flag in the... Black Flag.
Black Flag.
I said that in the first podcast, I'm saying in the 10th one. It's a miracle.
It's American.
It is American. That's actually French. But, yeah, the alien thing was what made me, like, reluctant to even play it in the first place. But
yeah.
it's still okay. I mean, they're not original. Then again, what Ubisoft game is, it's just a collectible thing.
Yeah.
Now, pretty much. Like, Wildlands, don't get me started with that. Holy shit. I've been going around getting all the collectibles, and I'm barely even close. And I'm just like, oh, my God, why am I doing this?
I agree.
I'm not achieving anything.
When are we playing Borderlands?
Eventually. I see why. I want to kill Hitler first.
Okay, we will kill Hitler first.
Kill Hitler first.
Okay, what's next?
Refugi again. It's like only Refugi and Gaima.
What the fuck, I've got like an eyelash in my eye.
I hate that.
Ah!
Oh my god, eyelashes are the worst in the world. Like, their sole job is to protect you from anything getting in your eye. But then they fuck up your eyes. Oh, like, what is the point of you existing?
It's out. It's all good.
Oh, my God. I hate them. I have a, now I have a red rational eye. Hatred.
Now I have, like, a red eye.
For them. I want to kill eyelashes. And I got beautiful, luscious ones, too. So it's so the worst.
My How much does it suck? Want my eyelashes.
Well, I should take them, then. Here you go.
Swear to God, I'll wake up and Kate will be, like, with a... plucking them.
Oh, tweezers. Ugh, yep. That's like a nightmare. Rafiki says, I do my job in my pajamas. So naked then?
Oh, that was a quote of us.
Yes. Me specifically.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, he's naked. No, he does naked.
No, fuck you. While I actually wear pajamas.
While looking at Matt Pack.
Matt Pat.
And touching himself sexually.
Oh, Mr. Patrick.
Oh, you're in the cupboard.
Because he's getting
it. Because he's locked in the closet.
I really want to meet him, though, in real life.
Yeah, it'd be cool.
I almost had the opportunity a couple of years ago, but he didn't come down because he was meeting his family.
Because he doesn't love you. You're nothing but a whore to him.
I'll work a bee. Jesus Christ. Okay, fuck you. No, I wear pajamas, damn it. I got a Doom t-shirt, pajamas a Doom 3 butthole. T-shirt that I got like pajamas with a butthole, like a butt flap.
For a penis to go inside of.
Oh, that's a gay joke.
Yeah.
You're so creative, Dan.
I know, right?
Congratulations.
Thanks, Edge.
For exaggerated facial expression. Thank you. James Geimer.
Geimer.
I can't do ventriloquist things. James Geimer. James.
James Geimer.
James Geimer. James Geimer. It's not easy. It annoys me that you can't do co-op mode in Halo 5. I know.
Yeah, it's stupid.
Well, you can do co-op, but you can't do split screen. I'm guessing you're trying to imply. Yeah. They said that 343 said that every single game they're making from now on, including Halo 6, will have split screen. So they're actually learning. Then again, the next Xbox will be able to do that because it's a fucking beast, apparently, according to the specs they just released.
Beast.
Apparently, it's almost this, it's
for
the same size.
6 months until it gets redundant.
Yeah, it's like computers.
And then 6.5K will come out and other stupid
What's the thing?
Shit.
If it can run, if the next Xbox, and it probably can run games at 1080p 60 frames per second, that's all we really need. 4K is a partial gimmick. Fair enough, if you've got like a massive screen and stuff, but 1080p is usually fine.
Yeah.
But the frame rate is the main thing. Like, I'd rather have 720p, yeah, with 60 frames per second than 4K at 30. Just makes sense. But yeah, apparently next Xbox the Scorpio best episode of The Simpsons is the same size as the Xbox One S.
Oh,
which is pretty impressive considering the performance. So
so you're trying to tell me I have to get rid of my Gears of War Xbox?
Yeah,
that'll make me sad.
I get to get rid of my Reach X. Actually, no, I didn't. I still have it.
I love my Gears of War Xbox. It makes a screaming sound whenever I turn it on and off.
Well, you make a screaming sound whenever you turn me on. But I'm sure you'll be right. Probably.
Oh, well. Anyway.
On to the next one. I believe that some of us already stand out. For example, Sea Lion. Absolutely. Unfortunately, Sea Lion's on a break.
He's dead.
Right now. Rest and rip. Tears. Tears of a tea lion.
God damn a tea lion.
We've said to Sea Lion, oh, Mr. Sea Lion, when you come back, the next podcast we're coming to comment in, you better comment at least 2 weeks worth of comments.
There you go.
We're counting on you to do that, otherwise you have lost your title as one of best commented persons.
We'll Plus still you love are you, a lion on the sea.
That makes sense. Yeah, because if you don't do that, then I guess you would have been lying.
Nah.
Murder me in my sleep. Fashion can go and fuck itself. Practicality will always triumph in the end. Yes! Mostly. Well, now I'm the worst possible person to say it from this, but a general fashion sense is probably okay.
Yeah.
Even if you're average, it's better than like wearing...
Don't just walk around with a million pockets sewed into everything. Yeah.
But even so, like I said, the pants that I have with like two pockets, which are lies, what's the point? If you're going to make it look like you have pockets, just have the fucking
pockets. It's like you're walking around and instead of having like the zip for practicality, you can just like undo a flap that your dick just hangs out of.
It's like those onesie suits.
Yeah, exactly. But for your dick. That'd be very practical, but it'd be a bit weird.
Onesie suit for your dick.
A onesie penis suit.
A one-eyesie. Barbecue Brothers, assemble! Always we will fight as one until the battle's won. One. Yes, I forgot what that was in reference to. I'll be honest. What was that?
I got
Barbecue
nothing.
Brothers? I don't know.
I got nothing.
Have we seen barbecues are great? I don't have a barbecue.
I don't know, but barbecues are great. I had one for my birthday.
Yes, we did.
It's fucking awesome. My dad's a great barbecue person.
Yay. I could cook it like a meme. Okay.
Con Air is awesome, as well as Gone in 60 Seconds.
Okay.
Which would you rather have? Well, which would you rather do? Have sex or steal cars?
Is that a genuine question? Because you already know my answer. Steal sex.
That was a quote from the movie.
I haven't seen it. Why are you facepalming? Obviously, I haven't seen it. Otherwise, I probably would have got that instantly. That's Lowrider. Which I associate with Driver Parallel Lines.
Well, I associate it with Gone 60 Seconds because it's the song they listen to, and then Nicolas Cage goes, and then fucking they go and steal cars.
Doc! This is just too bad to tell, but I wouldn't be surprised, actually.
No, because he's listening to it, and they're all just like, oh, yeah, and all my friends. And then he just goes, Lowrider. Let's go! And fucking they go off and steal cars. And he steals Eleanor. You know, that picture I have up on my wall.
Yes.
Yeah, the Mustang.
Yes.
Or the Shelby.
Well, I know the car. It's a pop culture thing, really, mostly. But, yeah.
I'm pretty sure he destroyed, or the person destroyed two of them making that movie.
How dare they?
If I remember correctly.
They're replicas, though, right?
I have no idea. They're not legit. They're most likely replicas. It
doesn't really matter.
And he goes and strokes the car and has sex with it.
I would believe you.
Yes.
If it was Nicolas Cage.
It is Nicolas Cage.
I know. That's why I said
okay.
That.
Okay. More from Goyna. Dan might have a nice ass, but Sedge has nice titties.
You're not wrong.
There you go.
I have very sumptuous breasts. Just squeeze them. You can actually grab a whole handful. Look at that. Like, grab a full on handful.
It's not a whole handful.
It's close. It's I'm getting close. Handful.
You're getting there.
All in good time. I was actually thinking of doing a bit of a... Like a not a fitness video, but just I mean we're working the other thing out. But like a progressy thing, so I can actually show progress, and people can actually judge me if I start failing again. Because I'm very squish, and I wanted to be not squish, but I lack the motivation and discipline.
Yeah,
I pretty much solely rely on you.
Woo!
And then you get sick, and then I get sick, and everything goes wrong. Or you fall downstairs in this case. But just like quitting smoking, you just keep on getting back on track.
Back to Gaima. Holy shit!
All that.
You guys look ugly as fucking 1080p.
Oh, 60. Aren't you a cockhead?
Oh, fuck you too, cunt.
Show your face and we'll judge your dick.
Bring it on, cockfag.
Hey, we can record in 4K if we need to. Okay. I've actually been considering recording in 4K for Xbox-related videos, because then we can do super close-ups in glorious high quality.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But then it'll just take forever to do the entire video.
No way.
And for the Premiere to render it.
It'll take the same. It'll take a little longer for Premiere, but if you render it on my computer, it'll be okay.
Well, it's not my computer that I'm rendering on.
Well, don't edit it then.
Okay.
Bastard.
Come on, Brady Simpson.
Come on, Brady.
You can
let's
do better
go.
Than this, you Pasty. Weak ass white boy.
Ooh, a challenge has been set.
Oh!
Has Brady Simpson actually posted in this
yeah,
one?
Yeah, boy. I don't know.
How dare you? No, that's a big paragraph.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Okay, read it in Rob Dyke's voice.
No.
Okay, read it in your voice.
Oh, wait, this is a paranormal normal thing. Ah, yeah, this is what we wanted.
My, yeah, that whole little beautiful. Thing about that. We're going in circles.
Alrighty, Rafugi. I'm done. No. I don't believe in the paranormal, comments. But my dad is a massive believer.
Okay.
I believe that there are aliens. There is a definitely lice on nut lice.
Lice?
I've already fucked up.
There's definitely life on the other planet.
There is definitely life on other planets.
You just go discover a new alien species, and then they're just like, guys, you better watch it.
It's almost a certainty. But I don't think they've come to Earth. But if you're not talking about aliens, my dad swears he has had two paranormal encounters. Back in the 80s, my dad used to work in IT, okay. Going to companies and setting up and servicing their computers and servers and stuff like that. I added that on for you. Never mind. He had to get the hard drive backup drives from an old safe. There was like 100 years old. He went in on a Sunday when no one else was there.
Okay.
He was the only one with the keys to the safe who was there. He went into the big wall, he went into the big walk in the safe. And is that what it's called? The big walk?
He went to do the big walk-in safe. He forgot a hyphen. What were they called? The big walk.
I don't know.
It sounds
and
like
a- got the backups and left without shutting or locking it. He left it unlocked because he had to go back and forth between the safe and the computers a lot, and to save time, he would leave it unlocked.
Right.
He went upstairs and fixed the computers, then came back down, and the safe was shut and locked. To this day, he thinks it was some sort of ghost or something, or someone broke in.
Or someone who also works there closed it.
Yeah. Oh, sure, shit, this humongous-ass, expensive-ass stuff inside is open.
Yeah. That seems like a general, reasonable thing to do, and they just stuck out with
it. But hey, realizing. If he was the only one there...
Maybe that's just how the safe works.
Yeah, maybe it's still closing on rails.
You don't know that.
I don't know. More recently, my dad is in construction. About a month ago, he was drilling holes for plumbing, and when you see a big drill, you need to have water on the drill to keep it from overheating.
Right.
It also softens the dirt.
Yep.
The drills he uses are fitted so that they pump water constantly. Ah, it's aqua filtered.
Oh no.
But, oh no. Anytime someone says, oh no, all I can think of is that freaking knuckles going, oh no. You have to connect them to a water source. He had the water connected and it was drilling. Then after he had done a few holes, he was midway through another one. Then all of a sudden he noticed the water had stopped flowing. He went to the valve to check and it was turned off. Those things are hard as fuck to turn, and he said it was off tight. The only two people there were him and his labourer, who was with him at the time. Spoopy. As for me, I've never had a paranormal encounter, and don't believe that any ghost or paranormal entities exist. I believe my dad is 100% though. Mm.
I think those are more easily explained than a lot of other paranormal things.
Still spoopy.
Like, still kind of scary. Cause like,
who's going around their afterlife going, let's turn off a valve. This safe door is open.
Ghost Nicola Cage, apparently. I said Nicola Cage. Oh, you should not do a Tesla movie.
okay, fair enough.
Electricity.
Fair enough. Rafugi.
Oh.
You two should get a shared Snapchat and post teasers on what shit you're making.
I mean, we could do that. Maybe we're actually making something that's worthwhile taking a picture of.
Yeah.
You know, once, like I keep saying, once uni's finished, that's the general thing. Once it's done, we'll be going like a lot more into it. So I reckon we could probably do something like that.
Yeah.
That'll be okay.
All right.
Manage that.
Major trip hazard.
Hello again.
Just when I thought the NBN couldn't throw any more bullshit, that's difficult connection, so we're not going to be setting it up, is complete cock fanny.
Balderdash! Cock fanny!
Cock fannery! If I told my boss one day that I'm not going to do something for a few years because it's difficult, he'd rip my head off. Exactly.
Exactly. You'd have it by now.
It's like you went to McDonald's. Yeah, I'd like a Big Mac, thank you. Okay, come back in a month and it'll be ready for you.
Give you a bun and just go, yeah, the rest will be coming like in 5 years or so. Just give it a sec.
It was too hard to make the burger, sorry.
Because it's Wednesday today in terms of the video release, not in terms of today, in terms of the today, because it's Sunday today.
We would officially have it on yesterday.
Yeah.
In terms of this video.
Oh, I'm excited. Even if it's for you, it's still exciting. Why are you not? Because you've already got decent internet from the start.
No, because it's probably going to fuck up somehow.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
But I'm going to get it this month. Well, available this month. But no, I need to see your speeds, Dan. The second it happens, I need to see your speeds. Then again, you're still with Telstra, so they're going to be shit.
No, they're not.
Why not?
They've assured us it's not.
Telstra have assured you something, so they're going to be shit.
After they blatantly lied to my dad.
Yeah, so they're going to be shit.
Anyway, major trip hazard. Prop hunt is my fave.
Fuck yeah. Gross.
What time zone are you guys in, though? Because some of us do have jobs.
It's like plus 10 or plus 11.
Something like that.
It's like the Sydney time zone, so use that as a reference. Well, whenever we do something, we'll have like a time converter thing. Yeah. We'll have like the major areas of like Los Angeles and stuff for time zone, probably.
All right.
But it'll all be planned in advance. Some of them could be just out of the blue. But again, we'll work to it when it comes to it, because we ain't going to do shit right now because we can't. Makes sense.
Major trip hazard. All the Marvel Netflix shows are pretty good, but Daredevil is by far the best.
Okay.
And as good as Tennant is in Jessica Jones, Wilson Fisk, Daredevil villain, is just on another level.
Wilson Fisk. I don't know who that is. I think the bad dude, because I've actually seen Daredevil, I downloaded the entire first season recently, and the second one. But I think the bad dude, at least in the first one, isn't it Kingpin? Like the Spider-Man villain?
I don't know.
Spider-Man villain, but he's played by...
you're the one that knows all the fucking celebrities.
Yeah, well, I know he's played by Vincent D'Onofrio. Who was the
DiCaprio.
He was the Joker from Full Metal Jacket.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Major Trip has listened to Sedge.
Okay, listening to Sedge's hallucination story is like, are you sure you didn't do drugs as a kid?
I agree.
Yeah!
That's how I was sitting there the whole time, just going like, are you sure you didn't do drugs?
I gotta say, I had a fucking massively... A fapping. I had an insanely vivid imagination as a kid, and then TV happened, and now it's gone. It's just all gone. That's actually kind of sad, but true. Which is really sad.
I still have a really good imagination.
It's still there. It's like it's not as strong as it was as a kid. But I've honestly, apart from like two beers, I've never taken drugs in my life, and I've refused marijuana once. I was really fucking proud about that. Fight the peer pressure. Actually, they're pretty okay with it.
It wasn't, yeah, wasn't a problem. Wasn't still, really peer pressure.
No, it was kind of just, hey, you want to try this? Not particularly.
Well, all it right. does help that we're like bigger than most people.
True, but I'm not an intimidating big person.
You are.
I'm just chubby.
But your height alone would intimidate people.
Yeah. Yeah, it's true. Cool. Major Trip hazard. We got away with everything in school as well. We managed to change the way all the school printers printed images, so instead of the actual image, it printed the coding for each pixel. A thumbnail would turn 11 pages of ASCII code. Well, a thumbnail would turn into 11 pages of ASCII code. Jesus Christ.
Wow.
The best part was the school IT tech didn't have a clue. He's a great IT tech then. No. In the end, the school had to replace all 80 printers.
Jesus Christ.
Bravo. That is fantastic.
Nice. That's cost the school more money, which your parents have to pay for.
Yay. They've already wasted money on those shitty interactive whiteboards, which they never use. Even unis do that. It's like, who uses them? They're a brand new technology, which is like the non-capacitive touchscreens. We have to like press it in just to barely use it. Fucking waste. But bravo, Mr. Trip Hazard. Very nice.
And now we know why kids these days have to pay for their own laptops.
Do they?
Yeah, Matthew has to pay for his.
Does he?
Oh, people at his school pays for his own laptops.
That's bullshit. Just buy your own like I did.
No, that's what he has to do. It. And it has to be their brand.
Oh, that's the worst.
It has to be done their way. That's really as well.
Fucking stupid.
So people pay for it, then they have full control over it. He can't install anything on it. And it's all so that he doesn't fall behind in class.
Yeah. That's dumb. Like, fair enough if they paid for it and they're all the same. Fair enough, like, having a uniform laptop, but not like, wearing it.
And it's full price. Pays full price for a laptop.
Not even a student discount.
No.
That is bullshit. This is Australia. Education, guys, it's so good.
Oh, crap.
I'm in 40 grand debt for something I don't even need. Lucky you. Okay, it was just a case of bad food poisoning, but I want to go back into hospital after that trip joke. We're going to start remembering what we actually said last time.
Yeah, I don't remember what he said.
Because we kind of just rambled for this entire duration. I agree.
Sure. I'm guessing.
Yeah, probably. And I reckon I think you were saying a lot of puns last week, weren't you? You dirty bastard.
I'm pretty punny.
That's the laziest pun joke.
Don't give a shit. It's still a pun.
It's like default pun joke.
Still a
it's
pun.
The vanilla pun joke.
Still a pun.
Vanilla's tasty. Mm. I like it. Oh my god! Dramatic pause. Bed Banana's Hitman is amazing, and he has excellent taste in music. I've got an entire playlist of just songs he uses in his videos. Fair enough. Yeah, this Hitman's fucking great. I respect the creators that don't need to, they can express humor constantly and actually make people laugh without needing dialogue in the slightest.
So not us at all.
No, I don't respect us in the slightest.
No, neither do I.
No. Fuck no. Oof. That sucks. But a no, he makes very good videos. I want to see more from him.
Yeah, he's funny.
Brothers in Arms is the Dire Straits song that you were thinking
yes.
of. And is arguably one of the best songs ever. I also really like Where Do You Think You're Going from Communique. I haven't actually heard many
You okay?
It's an album. I haven't heard many Dire Straits songs apart from the major ones, to be honest. I'll give them a look.
I pointed that one out to you the other night. Money's for Nothing.
Money for Nothing. Because I've only heard the radio station version of it. But there's a whole verse about...
several.
Insulting people, calling them faggots.
Yeah.
Like every single line.
Because he's talking about, you know, fucking young people and their music and stuff like that. And he calls a little faggot, does nothing, and he has to install refrigerators and TVs and... Yeah, he calls young people on MTV faggots.
I never knew that.
If it's MTV just... still had music in it, that is.
Yeah, now it's even worse.
Now it's not even music. Oh,
God, I hate it so much.
And
it
some is. Of their ads are so retarded. They're like just basic 3D bullshit.
Oh, that's, I like the 3D ads because they got like really cool like simulation things. Those are okay. Because they actually put effort into them instead of going, hi, no. I'm a slut.
No. The MTV ads that I'm talking about, the ones I've seen recently, have been like a pink 3D head that they just warp, put colours around it, and play weird music over the top of it.
Art. But again...
But it's edgy. Sedgy edge.
To be perfectly honest, and I'm sure you probably agree with me, that still has more effort than the actual shows themselves.
Yeah. Like ridiculousness. Yeah.
Never heard of it.
Good. God, that chicken ridiculousness is so annoying when she laughs.
I'm guessing there's a person who's solely there for sex appeal.
No, she's not even there for sex appeal. I don't know what. She's like the girlfriend or some shit of the guy that runs the joint. I don't know.
It's all bullshit.
I don't bother looking into it. It's just the chick's good laugh thinking. Is annoying.
So is my. It's like freaking the nanny.
Yeah.
Duty Calls, Call of Duty parody game. Great. Might make for a funny video, or if not, check out Total Biscuit's review of it. We've been quoting that since it came out.
Yeah.
Bloody screen, so real. It's like one of our most quoted
two
things
thumbs
from...
up and freaking flags.
Now I'm going to...
Now I'm here, soldier, to further the plot and give some emotional background.
Rank up, Sergeant Master Shooter Person. We're not just reading that off the screen.
I'm genetic evil man. Whatever the fuck the actual quote is.
Now I'm going slow motion for no reason.
Wasn't that made with Bulletstorm?
It was made for the as a Bulletstorm thing, which actually just came out as a re-release.
Yeah,
it made
you get better. The Duke Nukem if you pre-ordered it.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind playing that again. It did have a co-op campaign, didn't it?
No.
No? Never mind. That was a decent game.
I like Bulletstorm. I enjoyed it. Friggin' Marcus Phoenix as the main guy again.
That wasn't the main dude.
Yes, it was.
It was Steve Flynn.
Same person.
Who voices Cowboy Bebop.
They sound the exact same.
They really don't.
They do.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
They really... No.
Yes.
Steve Bloom and... Oh, I can't forget his name. Oh, I got his face. The voice of Bender. Oh, I had it. John DiMaggio. Yes, John DiMaggio.
They're both gritty, deep voices. They sound the same.
They do, but John's got a more broader range.
It's still very...
Steve's got more like a deeper...
I'm not talking about the actual range of the person doing it.
The characters.
I'm talking about those characters. They sound like the
same. Kind of similar. I mean, they're big chunky dudes in an Unreal Engine based game where you kill a bunch of people and gore and stuff. So, yeah.
Yeah. They sound like the exact same.
More from Major Trip Hazard. You are a contender for the comment person. Good job. We respect that. We don't have a name for it.
There you go.
Never had a paranormal experience myself, so I don't really believe in it, but I have a friend who says he's met a woman in the wrong bathroom of an old hotel. He didn't ask her what she was doing in the men's because she looked like she was washing blood and bits of brain off her hands. After poking around a bit, he found an old news article from around 70 years ago about a woman who smashed in her husband's head with a hammer in the men's bathroom of that hotel.
Nice, that's cool.
Personally, I believe he was just chatting shit or on drugs, knowing him, probably both. That's kind of cool.
That's pretty cool, though.
I like it. I like when, like people say, oh, I had this experience, it's just like bullshit, and you look in the backstory, it's like this situation.
Maybe it was a copycat murderer.
I highly doubt that.
Why not?
Because where would the murder be? They'd report
in
on
the
that
bathroom.
Too. Oh! Look in the toilet. Lungs. That's all that specific. Another YouTuber recommendation. The Mad Max 000 is great. Another possible collaboration there. I'm guessing he's Australian because of the 000 thing.
Yep.
If you have no idea who I'm talking about, sure, let's actually click on it for once.
Let's feature someone.
I'm going to click on here. So that was one nerdy or righty nerdy.
Well, this is brilliant. We managed to push it to a garage.
Is
so that...
Hey there. Y'all kept a girl waiting.
Sorry.
Which one's the prince?
Oh, the prince. That one will be me.
Hello, your highness.
Hello, your high.
You best save your apologies for Papa.
I don't want to save my apologies for Papa.
Roll her in while I'm still young.
Speak of the devil.
Prince Noctis.
And you must be old man Cockblock.
Now, I play the waiting game.
waiting game. Oh, brilliant. They almost beat the push the car game. And here we are. Welcome to Final Fantasy 15. You've got fantastic goggles, you know?
I like it.
Yeah, I like him. He's funny.
Sure. Contact us.
Someone. Someone put our name in his things.
Set us up. Be the matchmaker you
come on, help
wish
us
to be.
Please.
God, we don't want to put effort into this thing.
No, fuck off. It's not our job.
when major YouTubers actually come to us and say, want to collab? That's when they...
I'm alright with collaborating. That guy's pretty funny.
I don't even care if it's a person with like 3 subscribers. I want to just collaborate. Yeah, else we have chemistry.
Chemistry. Mm.
Go to go, guys. Is that what he said? He says, go to go, guys. See you next week, smiley face. Oh, a nice ass.
Hey. Yes,
bye.
For everyone watching, if you don't have anything to comment, comment nice ass.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Want to switch?
Sure.
Hang on. From Rufugi. I missed Trevor.
Rufugi, these episodes are just going to get longer and 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 longer.
Yeah, this the previous video, the one that you're commenting on, was 10 gigabytes. I had to upload with my professional data thing that I got, the 4G thing, and that took even longer. It took a whole night with the faster internet. Wow, kill me.
Neil's Eric Mayland.
That is Nima.
Neiman. How long does this take to upload?
Oh, a whole night.
Not a whole night.
Ooh, let's go about there. Bam.
Oh, no, there's some big words. I can't read big words. What the
Do you want me to read the big words, Dan? Because I can read the big words.
Yeah, you can read this one.
This is for Blitz Chill. Referring to top 8 or TQP. Oh, the Questionable Podcast. I forgot it can have an acronym. Cool.
It has. Oh, it does too.
TQP.
I did not.
Nice. We don't think.
You gave us an acronym.
Number 8.
I feel cool.
You think English grammar... English. You think English grammar is weird? Try Bosnian grammar on for size.
No, thanks.
For every noun in English, there is a noun in Bosnian. For every noun in Bosnian, there are 7 versions of that noun.
7 versions of that noun.
I'm going to try and actually read this. So, man is... Bosnian? Kovjek.
Kovjek. Kovjek? Kovjek.
I'm not going to bother reading all those. Kovjeka. So, yeah, there's 7 versions of that noun. That is insane.
Kovjeku.
What the fuck?
Kov.
7 fucking versions. Kovjeku. We're pronounced way wrong. We've just fucked up everything.
Kovjekom. Kovjeku.
And when KJH are in front of the letter I, yes.
I?
They change to C/Z/S. And if they're in front of the letter E, they change to the other ones.
Well, I'm too lazy, so fuck that.
Yeah. Of course, only at the end of the word with some exclusions, and I can give you some lessons on the craft for days. We won't learn. Bosnian is so hard to learn. Don't study Bosnian unless you want to come here, because almost everyone here is stupid and doesn't know English or any other language, as a matter of fact. Fair enough. I'm very glad I know the majority, not the majority language, but the general universal language in a way. Mm. I guess it is. Pretty much. I mean, Chinese is the other one, but I ain't learning Chinese. Because Chinese
very
people
privileged.
Scare me. Oh, yeah, of course. I tried to learn German. I sucked at it, so I didn't bother. I did a year of Japanese. I just remember that tofu tastes like old moist honey.
Old moist honey?
Yep.
Okay.
Assuming that was actually tofu I had, I don't know. It was nasty. Disgusting. Quantic AI! Beep boop! I just spat everywhere. I don't if I know I came across as a motionless serious git. It wasn't the intent. No, but your grammar's atrocious. That's fine.
Better than mine.
Well, I mean, you don't have to.
No, you're not an emotionless git, mate. We understand.
The fact that you're kind of apologizing now means you actually have some emotion within you.
We made you feel
extracted. Well, that's fine, dude. Do what you want, as long as you don't... You can be as emotionless, as grumpy, or whatever as possible.
Be who you are.
As long as you're not a complete thunder cunt and actually ruin people's lives and stuff.
Yeah. More from him.
Yep.
Or her. I usually play video games in college work. I'm doing game design, which involves console research, mayor modeling, and concept art.
Oh, fuck modeling. Not the striker pose, or the only pose that male models do. That's the scratching behind the head. Like, I have a very itchy spine. I don't understand that, but no. I did a...
And 3D. In regard to the disabled people making jokes about themselves getting a bit boring after a while and seems uncreative to me.
Well, unless you can make it creative. I mean, yeah. We're just like self-deprecating to the point of just like, you know, meaninglessness, which is okay because it becomes nullified, which means anytime anyone else insults us, we just go, yep.
We've made that joke about ourselves. I've heard this one.
This is just a variation of a joke I made last week.
This is at James Geimer. Anyone else, if you have any questions, just ask and I will probably answer it. Nice.
Cool. Thank you.
This is now a board for everyone to ask each other questions.
Yay! This is the community, part of the community. Yes.
Hey, I was going to bring this up with you.
Okay.
Have you guys heard of Earth Defense Force 4.1? It's a third-person shooter where you fight massive bugs and aliens. We played this.
Did we actually play it?
Yes, we did on the old 360. We played the first one, 20-something, 14, I think.
I don't think I played it on my console.
No, it was on mine.
All right.
It was late at night, and it was after we watched the... it was before we watched the dildo.
The dildo ad. Oh, you mean the butterfly ad from
the butterfly
SBS.
Dildo ad on SBS.
Yeah.
Late at night.
Oh, I remember that fondly.
Yeah, that was great.
Oh, yeah.
And they just walked up to people on the street and just like, hey, would you use this? And the lady's like, yeah, what's with the little butterfly? And
she it vibrates.
Yeah.
Into an actual butterfly.
That's a real. Yeah. I was actually going to suggest we play that.
I'm willing to. There's like a bunch of them.
It's fun. They're fucking fun.
I don't want to play in a really
they're
high
simple,
difficulty.
They're simple, but they're very addictive.
Yeah, I saw a Funhouse play one of them fairly recently.
Okay, for a film, have you seen Tickle? It's a documentary about the dark side of professional male tickling.
What?
I know it sounds like some sort of gay porno.
Yeah.
It isn't, which might disappoint you. I don't know. Look it up. Wait, there's male...
I'm about to say, yeah,
Two questions. There's professional male tickling, and there's a dark side to that? Is that supposed to be a racial joke, that you go and only tickle black men, but...
It's a Star Wars joke.
You will tickle the dark side.
Have you heard of Darth Plagueis, ticklish?
Can we look that up?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Professional dark tickling.
Just type in tickled.
Hang on. Professional...
tickling. Male tickling.
Professional. I'm sorry.
So is that like, is it a sport or is it like a service? Yeah. There you go.
Male tickling.
So it goes
on
to porn.
Pornhub.
First. Go on the fourth one. It's DeviantArt. It couldn't possibly be porn.
Oh, it's going to be so porn.
Here we go. Oh my god.
It's all porn.
It's actually not.
Hey, look, leopard.
I mean, the ones that are minus... Oh, sexy. That's not a snow leopard.
No, it's a tiger.
What's the point? It's a Bengal tiger. Bastards.
Okay.
Ticklish is really... Tickling is surprisingly common.
Can we actually show... Yeah, we can show all this.
Well, all the ones with minuses on them are porn, so we can't click on those ones.
Okay.
And please don't click on them, because I don't want to go through and censor this.
Okay.
Oh, Bowser.
There's some good old male tickling... Oh, you bad boy.
Hey, each to your own. I can't...
Oh, you bad boy.
We should definitely watch the Tickle documentary sometime.
Oh, yeah, sure. I mean, what the fuck?
I don't know. That's really fucking
weird. That's
weird. Then again, so are we.
Okay. Brady Simpson, are you going to stream on YouTube or on Twitch?
No.
Beam, most likely.
Yeah, we'll probably give Beam a shot. If something fucks up, we may end up resulting to YouTube just because it's already on YouTube, that sort of thing. But Beam is the main one we're going for just because it has low latency and we can also do it straight from the Xbox if we want to.
Okay.
Hey,
yeah. We got into more paranormal shit from Balmorog.
Oh, Balmorog.
Balmorog.
I'm going to say it like a ritualistic way now.
So a thing that happened to my cousin that was pretty weird was, one day somebody got ran over right outside of his flat and the body fell really close to his window. And the same night, while lying in his bed, he said that he saw a dark figure standing in his door frame and looking at him.
Ooh.
He said a few names of people living with him and the person, didn't respond and left. Next morning, he asked everybody if there were someone walking somewhere this night or other and sleepwalking, and everyone said no.
Now, that's more paranormal than the other one. That's actually kind of fucking creepy.
Okay, we got, hey, nice ass backwards. But he said hi, nice ass in a different way. Okay,
well, so backwards is the ass nice high.
Sah.
Oh no!
I thought Dan is going to say money shoot.
Money shot. She says money, shoot. Yes.
It says shoot.
That is a reference to iDubbbz. Oh. If you don't know that, he does a bad unboxing video where he goes, money shot, and then he opens it in front of the camera, and it's mostly a dildo, or I think the recent one was coyote urine.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Okay.
Hey!
More balloon-a-log.
Go on.
There will be less questions this week because my mind is full of shit right now.
Fair enough.
I might add some later.
Okay.
Number one, pros and cons of living in Australia. Oh, okay.
Well, the pros are quite a lot.
A lot. We have a fantastic standard of living. Walking down the street.
True. There's less shooting.
There's not really much. Well, there's a lot of thievery, but nothing of a personal level where someone can get hurt.
No.
It's more vehicles and breaking into houses when people aren't there. And
yeah. So, there's a general not that ridiculously high crime rate.
Healthcare's pretty good. Healthcare's all right.
Pretty good. The food's fantastic.
Yeah, everything's a bit expensive.
Weather's
That's
okay.
A bit of a con, yeah. Weather's all over the joint. That's living in Melbourne, generalised, in the entire of Australia. It's just hot.
As a whole, it's so many things we take for granted every day that are very positive,
and just we can't exactly just single them out because we don't actively think about them.
Yeah, but the cons.
The cons are
internet,
government, price, government,
old people. Not all of them, but a lot of them.
The lack of really caring about those who really need help.
Yeah. Like the whole sending bullshit they're doing recently.
Yeah, Australia has the bad habit of you have to go and find help instead of them necessarily being able to find you.
That's very true.
Like I said, I don't know if I mentioned it last time in the podcast when I was going for my U session with the Army. I walked down Swanston Street
and there was just
so many people homeless with children and all that kind of stuff, and it's not cool. I mean, that's an epidemic everywhere.
Yeah.
Everywhere has that, but I'm saying, yeah, just in general. Yeah.
Another con is the pricing, just general expenses.
Yeah.
Especially housing, which is like, the average housing price in like a year or two, possibly even now, is like $1 million.
Yeah.
Which is fucking insane. And you got the baby boomers going, oh, no, we didn't do anything. You got to get a job and you got to do all this stuff. And we did this when we were young. And it's just, they're actually responsible.
For an example of housing prices, how they've inflated over the last even 10 years. My parents bought a house and they bought it for basically a third of $1 million. It is now...
So, 350 grand.
It was around that. And basically 350 grand. It's now worth $1.2 million.
Fuck. That's all right.
We haven't done anything to it. I mean, my dad's fixed up the backyard a bit and that's it. It's not... I would never pay that much for my own house. I would barely pay the $350,000.
It's not a bad house.
No, but it's not worth $1.2 million. No. No way in hell.
No.
But it's only because of its location that's happened.
Mm. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, I know. I was like, Mom, Dad, fucking sell. What are you doing?
Exactly.
Fucking kick me out. I'll come back and I'll live in a fucking van or something. I don't care. Sell and get a better house.
They can even downsize now that they have less kids.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. I have a lot of sisters and brothers, by the way.
But now, it's just you and your brother.
Just me and my little bro.
And your dad and your mum.
Used to be a lot more people in the house.
So now they actually...
It's worth so much.
That's what my parents want to do. They want to kick us out and then get a small apartment.
It's not worth 1.2. Downsize. It's worth something like $1 million.
Still?
Yeah, no. It's still bloody
good.
Oh, that's right. The bloke who came and investigated or looked into the house said if they did a few things, it'd be worth 1.2.
That's all right.
Hmm. Anyway, were you involved in any accidents?
Yes.
We're going to guess we're talking about cars and motorbikes and stuff like that. Yeah, we have been. You go first.
What was your worst accident?
You go first, I'll think.
All right. I've been in a sideways car.
I've done that in a bloody paddock with a Commodore.
It wasn't in a Commodore. I went camping with my dad, his mates, and one of my mates, that sort of thing. It was okay. It wasn't too bad. And we were driving back. Dad and his friend, I'll admit... I'm going to say it. He decided to finish off the rest of the margarita mix with his friend.
Good job, Dad. You're a great example.
He's normally an okay driver, but after this, I have my doubts.
Oh, no, I'm sure he's an okay driver when actually, because, he hasn't got, like, a lot of alcohol in his system. Even
so, because he was an okay driver, it also saved our lives, because this could have been a fatal one. And we're driving back with a Subaru Impreza.
Impreza,
my apologies. Which was my mum's car.
That was a prized possession. That'd be the Generation 3 2.5-litre Subaru Impreza.
It was
sedan.
A silver one.
Sedan, yeah.
And we were driving back with a massive trailer in the back, which had all the stuff, had like a tent and everything, and had a whole bunch of things. It was heavier than the car, almost.
Poor rear diff.
So, what about the rest of the car? We're driving back, probably only got maybe 120 metres, well, a few Ks actually, down the road pretty much. And this is in the country. And there's a bit of a ditch to the right, and there's like a bunch of trees and stuff, and on both sides, really. For whatever reason, the side of the road had like a massive bump, like a half a meter size, just a big old fucking bump in the road in the side. And Dad must have slightly swerved just a little bit off the road. We're still on the road, but just on the side. Ba-boom, trailer starts sliding, carries us to the side. If Dad didn't turn in the last second, there was a giant freaking tree. We would have hit that about 80 Ks.
Yeah.
Maybe 100? Dead.
Yeah.
Almost guaranteed. That would have killed us completely. But he managed to just avoid that. We got sideways in the ditch. I was on the left passenger side, so I was pretty much up, looking down on my friend. I'm just like, okay. Well, my last words would have been shit, 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 fuck, shit, 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 shit. Alan, of course, mocked me for that, but I said, it's better than screaming like a little fucking girl. Those were probably my last words. Just
nice. Just swearing a lot. Fuck, 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 shit.
But, we actually, everyone was okay. Barely, not even a scratch. Actually, completely fine. I also, in a little bit of not intentional revenge, I even stood on Alan's face almost nice. Just to get out of the car.
Nice.
But the car was fucking ruined. That was to be taken down, which is a shame because it was Mum's best car. It was a freaking good car.
No, so, they're good cars. Subarus are good until fucking...
Until they turn sideways into a ditch.
Nah, the rear matting seals on them fucking pop off and the transmissions are bad on them.
Probably wouldn't even fit in a Subaru now. I've heard they're pretty small.
No, they're fine.
Are they?
I can fit them. Anyway.
How was yours? Your worst one?
My worst accident.
That's probably my only one.
I've had a few. I've never had a car accident when I was driving, personally, on the road. I have when I was in a paddock. I was going sideways in a Commodore, and there was a tree stump we didn't see, and I ended up bending in the entire rear axle underneath the car, and the car flipped a few times. But we had a bolt-in roll cage in the damn thing, so I was completely fine. It was actually fun. I got a bit of whiplash because I was going inside the freaking car. That was...
Okay.
That hurt a bit, but yeah, the roll cage and the raised seat did its job. But the worst accident, really, I've only been in two on the road where I've been responsible for myself, have been on the motorcycle.
Ah, yes.
The very first time a week after I had the bike, I went out late at night with some friends, didn't judge a corner correctly and cut a corner a bit too sharp, hit a gutter and went through a bloody fence.
Silly Dan.
I also then got back on the bike and rode off before the person could come out and realize that I had gone through someone's fence. In other words, I got away with knocking down an entire wooden fence. And all the bike suffered was a scrape on its transmission, like cover. I was bleeding like down my leg and nasty stuff because I got stuck in a gutter.
All right, but it wasn't like really terrible. It was
I've got inside. A bit of a scar there and that's about it.
Yeah.
The Kevlar jeans I was wearing did its job.
Fair enough.
Good. My motorbike's fine. I still have the same one. The second one, also on the same bike.
Yay, same day.
Was about 6 months ago. It would have been 7 months ago, I think, around that.
Right.
It was... I was going towards work early in the morning, and it's 6:30 in the morning, going through the Aspendale Garden District, and a lady decided to jump from the right-hand lane into the left-hand lane without checking when I was going 70 k's an hour. She forced me to drop my bike. Instead of me running to the side of her, I tried to go around her, and I dropped the bike, and then I nearly rolled in front of a bloody truck. That was in the same lane as me.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that wasn't fun. Because you know that scene in Toy Story when the fucking truck at the service station goes like this and then stops right in front of his face? That was pretty much me.
You would have been a Dan cake.
The truck stopped pretty much where the mic is in front of me. And I was shitting myself.
Steady stream.
The worst bit was the lady drove off and I never found her.
Oh.
In a Mazda CX-7 that was maroon red with pink butterflies all over the back window.
Maybe that was just like a bit of karma for you.
And I'm pretty sure she had a kid.
Had
a kid. It's dead now because I killed it. No.
Jesus. I feel no guilt. She drove away. It's her fault.
But yeah, it threw me at least 5 meters from the bike in front of a truck and scared the absolute shit out of me. And the truck driver was absolutely horrified. Like, he thought he had killed me.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be scary for everyone involved. Yeah.
And I got pulled out by some little old lady and I was like shaking and adrenaline going off and bullshit.
I just imagine lifting up like a freaking superhero and just like, are you okay, Sonny?
But then I rode to work with a bent shifter and the end of my handlebars all scraped up and shit now and bent in, which pissed me right off, and I still haven't fixed it because I just don't have the money to at the moment. And yeah, no, wasn't fun.
Fair enough.
That's the worst I've been in. But as for a car accident, I've wrapped a car around a tree while I was trying to drift. That's about it.
That's so casual.
It was a $200 Commodore VN that had 2 weeks left on the registration, so we wrapped it around a tree.
It's cheaper.
And we left it there and it disappeared in 2 days. We don't know what happened to it.
The tree absorbed it, gained its energy.
Oh, and I know some of the blokes I used to go TAFE with, they bought an old 1995 Nissan Pulsar and we took it off roading and bush bashing, went through a river, it just kept on going, bloody thing was tough as nails. So we shot it a couple of times to see if we could have any fun with it. Yeah, we just left it full of holes and again, disappeared in like 2 days. We came back to shoot it some more with a few shotgun shells and just gone.
Oh, was it there and then it disappeared when you were staring?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Ooh, that's terrifying.
Yeah, no, someone
that's
had moved
it. That's the true
paranormal
experience.
We don't know who did it.
Yeah,
it was in the middle of nowhere. Sort of
magic. Kangaroos took it for a drive.
Kangaroos did it. Like, fucking hell, mate, look at the Pulsar.
The kangaroos. I didn't know they were bogans.
Yeah.
Question the third. For some reason, there's a link, even that's not supposed to be. How long ago was this package sent? Talking about the package sent from the Polish fans fucking hell, like a month ago.
Ages ago, we don't think it's going to arrive.
No.
We've already let the blokes know.
That's so annoying.
But yeah, that's very annoying. We were looking forward to it.
Which is why, yeah, probably won't do any like fan mail stuff like I mentioned before, so.
And he finishes off saying, yeah. I will try to add more questions down the line, but now it's late and I'm sick, so.
You didn't! How dare you? Well, you still got this podcast now, Mr. Moore.
And last one from James Geimer with a few replies. We have got
viewers.
The current state of the Great Barrier Reef saddens me deeply.
What a depressing end.
And Refugee says, yeah, I went there in January 2010 and went to about 5 different reefs and 3 of them were pretty barren, but 2 are very lively. Also, I found a beer bottle some arsehole just dumped overboard. Like, what the fuck, cunt? But it was awesome, though. I recommend anyone who hasn't seen it in person to give it a shot. I want to do that, but I haven't.
Before it's dead, because that ain't going to last.
I haven't been there yet. James Gunn responds with, yeah, it would have still been all right back in 2010. Now it's nearly gone. Also, divers are told to leave rubbish in. Are told to leave rubbish down the reef, except for floating plastic, because it eventually becomes part of the reef and
that's okay.
Creates a home. Yeah, that's it's right. Like if you see a sunken wreck.
Yeah, a glass bottle's fine. That's actually completely fine. You get, like hermit crabs go around and stuff.
Mm.
But for plastic shit, it's just not.
But yeah, beer bottles still not cool. Bottles and stuff like that, probably not. I'd probably say no.
No.
But I do like, you know, buckets or bullshit like that, so that they can actually grow on. And then Quantic AI has adds his little bit with joys of humans, we care after we kill it.
Yep,
I agree. Indeed, sir, madam, it's sir. Okay, so Quantic AI is a sir.
Confirmed. But yeah, the whole barrier reef thing is so not cool. Bullshit. And it's just like, oh no, we better make a change. Oh, whoops, it's already completely dead. It's like, It's like shooting someone in the fucking heart and they're slowly bleeding out, like, oh, I'll save you. Let me patch that up. Except they don't even try and patch it up. They just go, oh, that's a shame.
Yeah.
And move on, says me, the hypocrite.
It's a bunch of shit.
Anyway, no, it is all. Genuinely terrible. Oh, shit, that's it.
That's it.
That's under 2 hours again.
Yeah, we did it quickly.
Cool.
We need a question for this week.
We do, or a general prompt of discussion for you guys.
Yes.
You do this one. I do the last one.
I don't know.
I'll try and figure something out, too. I think it's one topical. Not even that. Just anything. Really. Wow, we suck at this. Hey, here's one. Here's an actual decent one. What type of video would you like us to see doing? What video would you like us to see doing? You can give any sort of prompt, anything beyond that. We may even actually consider doing it. But yeah, like I said, once the NBN comes around, we're going to try and broaden our horizons quite a bit. Yeah. Not just with general things, but like a whole bunch of stuff, which means there'll be less gaming videos, probably. But
there'll be less gaming videos, but we'll be doing other stuff as well.
Yeah, we got a lot planned and a lot to be planned. But what videos, or just in general content, doesn't have to be a video. What things do you think we should make?
Once the streaming starts, we'll probably end up doing podcasts in real time.
This is all 3D animated. That's why it takes ages to upload.
No, in real time.
Yeah, that'll be all right.
We'll do a Q&A in real time, really.
Yeah. But when the time comes, and even if it doesn't work, because again, and we will definitely be uploading those afterwards too. We're not just going to do it one-off and just leave them, assuming we can figure out how to do it. Because again, we'll suck at streaming for ages.
Yeah.
Because it's not exactly super easy. But so what do you want to see us do? Is the general prompt for the next questionable podcast. But apart from that, I don't think I have anything to talk about at the moment. Nothing in particular.
Nope.
Check out the film theory I'm working on coming out soon.
And any of you that haven't been commenting, because there's more than, we've got like, what, 5-6 people doing it, and I'm seeing a few more. I'm seeing more views on there than 5 or 6. Comment, damn it.
How dare you?
Leave us a comment. We want to hear from you.
Yeah, we don't care if
you... Be our friends!
They are our friends. We have so many friends.
Making so many friends.
So many friends!
All right, thanks, guys.
Thank you for watching. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
That was the wrong outro, mate.
Oh, yes.
Thank you for watching. Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
We are the oh, yes, men.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Again, we'll probably never have like a proper outro, really, apart from
now. But always, who we are. This has been.
That's not always. Sometimes we say, like, we go off key, even like right now, I'm actually not doing it. Because what I should be saying is, Sedge.
And Dan.
Rambling on about bullshit.
Bye.
See you next time. Don't leave us.